Alright, swap faces on three. One, two, three. How was that?
Good. How was mine?
Sort of like a drunk rabbit.
Yes, then I'm improving.
Alright, Mr. Webster. Are you ready to commence Operation Freshman Ice?
Indeed I am, Mr. Stone.
Oh yes, it's hot. Hotter than hell. Oh yes, it's hot.
Hi, I'm Jason.
I'm Danny.
I care.
How are we doing?
Not so well. Plan B?
Plan B.
Yo, man, watch it!
I'm so tough. I don't care about being suspended on the first day.
Yeah, well, I've been to jail.
Man, that's not the script.
Twice!
What does it take to get noticed around here?
Hey, Jason.
Candace. Hi, how are you? How do you like the school so far?
You're flies on nun sport.
Danny, I thought we did a zipper check.
I'm sorry I didn't thoroughly study your downtown area.
Well, I thoroughly studied your downtown area, dude.
Last resort.
The principal's a big butt!
I kissed a teacher.
I hated Pulp Fiction!
Man.
Sorry, guys.
Sam, how could you?
I thought we were friends.
Come on, Jason. Let's just go find our lockers.
Well, here we are. Great location, too. Only 15 miles from each of our classes. What's the matter, man?
We messed up.
Oh, come on. We put too much pressure on ourselves. Who cares?
I just wanted change. I needed change.
I think we just tried too hard.
I'm just sick of it, Danny. I'm sick of not getting a second look. I'm sick of not having a girlfriend.
Well, Candace was obviously interested.
She told me my fly was down.
You know what I got from that? She was looking.
You're totally okay with this.
What?
With things staying the same.
Jason, man, it's the first day. Who cares if people saw us in our underwear? For the guys, it's just a precursor to the locker room. For the girls, it's just a precursor to the storm I'm bringing.
It's the same stuff, Dan. Getting pants, getting laughed at. I can't wait till college for new stuff.
Jason, you're being really melodramatic.
That is one of his many traits.
Hiya, Mary.
What is it this time, Jason?
Operation Freshman Ice melted.
Do I have to give you guys the be yourself speech?
I'm starting to think that being myself isn't enough.
Enough for what?
Jason just wants to be loved by everybody.
How am I the only one upset by this?
Relax, Jason.
No, I'm done. I need things to be different. Maybe our plan wasn't the best way to go about it, but I can't handle another 4 years of pathetic Friday nights.
So hanging with us makes for a pathetic Friday night.
You really should know what I mean, Dan, but you don't.
So, you wanted this bad, huh?
What the heck?
I've dealt with some doozies, but this one's really shallow, Jason.
Well, what are you doing in here? Who are you?
I have a few names. Yes, I saw it. Wasn't impressed.
Did I just say that out loud?
So is there, something you want here, lady?
This isn't about what I want, Jason. Hi. I'm the devil.
Cute nickname.
I can assure you, it's no nickname.
Right. So, how about we continue this conversation outside? You know where other people can see us talking? Oh my God! What the hell was that?
Devil, Satan, Lucifer, Carl, whatever you want to call me.
Personally, I like Scratch.
Stay away from me, this isn't real.
You really want everyone's approval, don't you, Jason? You need it. Well, you need enough to see me. I only appear to serious investors.
Investors?
4 years of success. I'll pave the way to your future. No more of this same stuff, Jason. That's my final offer.
Am I missing something here?
Look, we both want something. You want to be noticed, and I want your soul.
What do you mean, like, in my shoe?
Cute. Look, you really need to think about how much you want this.
This is ridiculous. Stop it, please.
Jason, you're a nobody. Face it, without me, this little emptiness you have, this need for approval, it won't be fixed. And look, I'm not telling you not to be yourself. That would be good advice. I'm just saying, I can make yourself better. All right, then.
Oh!
How did that get in there? Okay, so. 4 years, whole high school career. I set you up for success. Then at the end, I come back for my part of the deal.
My soul.
You got it. Sign here.
I don't have a pen.
A pen?
So how exactly is this gonna work?
I come in here, I poop, then I leave. It's pretty much that simple.
Hey! We're sort of scouting for promising looking freshmen to work on the yearbook. Interested?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Thanks!
Thanks. See ya.
Is it a freshman?
Yo, freshman, right? yeah. Basketball tryouts this weekend. You any good?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Here, take this.
Okay.
We're kinda fast, so we're gonna need some decent players for out there. We lost some of our best guys last year. So let coach know that John sent you, and oh yeah, by the way, what's your name?
Jason Stone.
Alright,
see you.
That's what I like to see, a freshman taking initiative. No hesitation. What's your name?
Jason Stone.
Jason, what do you think about joining student council? You got Lederman all over you.
Dude, you're done?
Yeah.
God, you suck.
I've been tutoring your sorry butt since freshman year. Don't tell me you still want me to hold your hand.
No, I want the freaking answer, number 43.
You can hold my hand, Jason.
You guys are gonna get me in trouble.
Yeah, right. Miss Kempton loves you. You could take a poop on her desk and she'll give it an A.
Poop.
Quiet.
I should punch you for asking.
I should punch you for not, yeah.
Jason is just not that kind of girl, Rick.
Oh, shoot, speaking of Candace, she said you guys can come to her graduation party on Friday if you want.
Yeah, I'm game for that.
Definitely. Definitely.
Yeah, just bring your bathing suits, you know, because the pool's going to be open, so. Oh, shoot, I'm sorry, man. Danny. Hey, how you been, man? You haven't returned my text or anything. How'd that New York thing go for you? I didn't hear back from you about it.
Missed one, bro.
Danny, just ignore. Well, Danny, wait. Candace is having a graduation party.
I'm busy. Other plans.
Oh, well, it's Friday if you change your mind or whatever.
I don't know if I can handle it. It sounds like such a rad party, and I've just gotten used to pathetic Friday nights. Why change now, right?
Damn, I'm trying
here.
Here
he is!
Try some!
Wait, Danny, wait!
He spit on my face. He spit on my face! Oh my God, he spit on my face!
I know you care about him, Jason, but he's not gonna give in.
I know.
I can only tell you, you didn't do anything wrong so many times.
Well, I could hang out with you guys more.
You have other obligations. Danny, he understands that. He just doesn't like it as much.
Yeah, obviously.
He just misses you. Can't blame him. So, what are you doing Friday? Got room for a pathetic Friday night?
I'm never gonna live that down, am I?
I'm just joking, Jason.
Yeah, joking bitterly. Nah, but, yeah, we could all hang out if Danny's... Shoot. Candace is having a graduation party. I kinda have to...
It's fine. I'm gonna be late, so I'll see you later.
Well, you could come if you want to the party. I mean, I'm sure Candace won't mind.
Oh, really? I mean, I just...
Won't mind what, babe?
Hey, Candace, I mean my mouth. I was just telling Mary about your party on Friday. It's cool if she comes, right?
Well, I sort of had a guest list. My parents only wanted a specific number.
Oh, no, it's fine. Don't worry. I wouldn't want to impose my presence.
Presence? It's not a birthday party.
Maybe Saturday, Mary.
Right, I'll talk to Danny.
Come on, Jason.
Come on!
And yet, you still talk to him.
You know, we're not his only friends, Dan. You know what? I'm not even gonna waste my time with you.
Well, look at him! I should feel bad for him. He needs this so bad, it's sickening. And you're fine with it, with his little new personality.
He's not the only one who's changed, Danny. Listen, we're graduating next week. Grow the hell up.
Where are you going?
To the bathroom. Is that cool?
Don't take too long, though. You need to walk me to math.
Hey, Jason. Great job at the game.
Yeah, no surprise there.
Thanks. Anyone in there? No.
Get your head in the game, man. You were wide open.
Or what is this? Are you...
Time's up. It's the end of the fourth quarter.
Okay, all right. I want to ask you a question.
Well, anything for you.
You're the devil.
That was more of a statement, Jason. I thought you were getting good grades now.
So why do you look, you know, like my age? I didn't really think Satan was a kid.
Well, I present myself in the form most fitting for the situation.
What do you really look like?
I could show you, but, are you fond of your face? Well, I just mean, like, it would probably melt off. You know, I really don't think that's such a good idea. We should just stick to business, you know? I think sometimes I have a little too much fun. Which reminds me, do you ever see Jersey Shore?
No. I mean, I know what it is.
That's all me. No, seriously, back to business. Okay.
All right, go!
I'm not giving you a breast exam, Jason.
Sorry. Never exactly sold my soul before. I don't know how this works.
Oh, right. Well, first... Are you happy with our deal? Did I successfully hold up my end of the bargain?
Yeah, I guess.
Are you happy, Jason? Did you get what you wanted?
Yes. This is what I wanted.
Good! Let's go.
What? Where?
Oh my gosh! To Mexico! Where do you think?
What, you mean hell?
Very good, Einstein. You'll get to meet him.
Why? Is there some sort of soul extractor thing?
Excuse me?
I'd like to take out my soul with.
You can't take the soul out, Jason. I'm taking you.
No, that wasn't part of the deal. You tricked me.
Your soul isn't some little ghost inside of you, Jason. That's not how this works.
I just thought that you'd, like, own it until I died. I didn't think that... God.
Whoa. Leave him out of this. Here, look.
Would you stop that?
4 years. That was the deal. Now let's go before it gets cold down there.
No. No, I won't!
Jason! Hey!
I'm so sorry, Candace.
Where'd you go? I was waiting outside the bathroom for like 4.5 minutes. I'm gonna be late now.
Super sorry, Candace, but enjoy math!
Jason! Hey! What the heck?
It's not my birthday.
We know!
Wait, where are you going, Jason?
Jason? Your butt looks good in those jeans!
Hi.
Hi, Jason!
Oh, nice of you to join us, Mr. Stone. Oh,
I would have missed it for the world.
Apparently, we're getting a new student today. You must be her.
Must be.
Class, this is...
JC. JC Stone.
Oh, how funny. His name is Jason Stone.
Get out of town!
Try to catch what you can of the review, I guess. Take a seat. Jason, come on.
Yeah, dude.
Okay, I'll collect the essays later, but first, we're gonna start going over those three plays we read last week. Hopefully that quiz I gave you was a good refresher.
Look, I didn't know that.
Now, I want you to go over...
I'm just so not ready for the final,
bro. And of course, there's a struggle of whether or not the main character will keep his end of the deal. Now, don't forget about the book in there, because next week there's gonna be a quiz on that. Jason, what are you doing?
Pee! I have to do it.
Excuse me, do we have to sign out to use the bathroom in the school?
Oh, of course. Jason, sign out before you go.
Go to class.
What's the matter with you, baby? I feel like you're avoiding me.
No. You're just imagining things. Bye.
You know what, Jason? Go to hell!
Well,
we're done!
Okay. Can you pick, like, one form to stick with? Because this is making it really difficult for me.
It's not your fault, really. Like I said before, I just have too much fun.
We can work something out here, man, please.
The side out cheating was good, right?
I wish I had been filming it. Your face is wonderful. Wonderful.
You know, that's the first time that I ever had a chance to do that bit. But you would think after all these years, the opportunity would come up. But surprisingly, I really don't get very many kids in school. Too much fun.
Oh my God. Can we?
Yeah.
Come on! Thank you guys so much.
Jason, what the hell was that?
I don't know. We need to get out of here.
Jason, what is going on?
It's really hard to explain.
Well, please try, because I'm trying to figure out why we just had to pull you from Ghost Rider's weapon of choice.
I sold my soul to the devil. I sold my soul to the devil in exchange for all of the good things that have happened in the past 4 years.
Jason, that...
The most pathetic thing I know. Look, we gotta go. The devil is here.
All right, kid. We're done here. Let's go.
Let me see the contract.
I'm sorry, and you are?
Miss Devil, my name is Daniel Webster. I'm the head of the Noam High Law Club, and I do believe I'm suing you.
Oh my gosh, I'm having deja vu, Stone and Webster! Mary, right? Nice one, big guy. On what grounds are you suing me, young man?
Just let me see the contract.
What are you doing, Jason?
I thought the ear thing.
Where's the signature?
The blood.
Miss Devil, I do believe you have a child on your hands.
This is absolutely adorable. You really expect me to do this?
Yes. Look, I know I'm not a real lawyer, but I know him. Jason might have been a little misled, but he would never agree to this.
Jason, we're peacing out.
Oh, wait, Scratch. It could be fun.
Fun?
Well, yeah, think about it. You've been having a ball all day, am I right? The sign-out sheet thing. Brilliant.
You liked it!
Well, yeah. Come on. How often does someone have the guts to challenge you? And when they do, you usually win, don't you?
Of course.
So, have some fun.
Jason Stone, you just tempted the devil. All right, Mr. Webster, what are your conditions for this trial?
An all-American judge. And jury.
Should have known. Anything else?
If we win, Jason gets his soul back.
And if I win? What's in it for me? I could take him right now without all the trouble.
You can have Mary's soul.
Hey!
Fine. My soul.
Then no!
Great! Your soul and Mary's soul. Deal!
No, wait, I said...
To sweeten the deal. And an all-American jury.
What's this? I asked for an all-American jury.
You never said they had to be living, or not from hell. This group here was responsible for the death of their 32-year-old math teacher. Beat him to death with their textbooks. Cruel, but also pretty funny. So they stole a bus, tried to escape, and one Mack truck and a broken red light later, bam, property of Scratch. To put your odds in perspective, they still think it was legal for them to kill the man. You were right, Jason. I am having fun. Judge.
Are you serious?
I'm joking.
Sup? So what's his deal? Like, is he like a demon or something?
Nope. Old Jeremiah there is just kind of a jerk. Very hard to please.
Okay.
To put your odds in perspective, he hated The Dark Knight.
Oh my god!
That was a wonderful movie.
Be Satan! Will the defendant please rise?
Excuse me. I just want to make sure this is legit. Where's the bailiff?
Defendant, rise!
That'd be me.
How are you, Scratch?
Good, good. How's Becky?
Dead.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. Anyway, guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
Wait, I'm sorry, of what exactly?
She's in wrongful possession of my best friend's soul.
Right. State your case or whatever.
Okay. Well, I'll start by asking the jury a simple question. What country is this? Well, that's right. It's America. I will now present to you Exhibit A. Mr. Stone is an American citizen. Born in America, raised in America, and most importantly, given American rights. I'm sure with a postponed court date, I could provide the documents necessary to prove this.
Just go on, Mr. Webster.
Okay. Now, according to the American legal system, a citizen is only bound to a contract that is signed, as in with their signature. In ink. Nowhere in our Constitution is there a law about a contract signed in blood. Now, as far as Mr. Stone is concerned, you know, with him being under the protection of the American government, this contract is null and void. Both null and void. So, yeah, that's all.
Danny, that was great.
I might have underestimated you, Danny. Even your much older and, quite frankly, much smarter counterpart didn't lay that one down. Congratulations. However, I'm afraid I have to respectfully, how should I say, smack that trash right to the flow. You see, kind jury members, I operate under a different law. My law. And my law pertains to souls and souls only. Mr. Stone here signed a contract under my law, under my terms, in my specific field. I'd very much enjoy for you to read about your government's side on foreign laws and contracts signed under a different government. Because when Jason Stone signed my contract with his blood, that was under my government. Just consider me the president of another country. Somewhere from the, Deep South. Honestly, Danny, who do you think has more jurisdiction over Jason's soul? The President of the United States or the Lord of the Underworld?
Well, a couple years ago, people would have told you that's the same guy.
Clever, Mr. Webster. But besides the point, do you have a rebuttal?
He wasn't there. In hell.
I'm sorry, who are you?
Mr. Stone's other lawyer.
Other lawyer?
Let her speak.
Jason was here when it happened. Right?
Yeah, I was in school.
In America.
Well, I believe that what my associate is getting at is that once you brought the contract onto American soil, the contract is void. Is that correct?
Yes, correct.
Interesting. Scratch?
Mr. Stone, you sure you were here?
Yeah, I was in the bathroom down the hall.
And when you opened the door to said bathroom, what was it you saw?
Fire. I saw fire.
You saw fire. Now, is it a common thing in America for bathrooms to have doors that lead to fire?
No, it is not.
So, Mr. Stone, maybe you merely thought you were here. Yes?
I thought it was a portal, like earlier.
I don't come to you for the first time, Jason. You come to me.
Well, Mr. Webster, do you have anything else?
Mr. Webster?
I'm so sorry you guys got dragged into this. I'm such an idiot.
It's okay, Jason.
No, it isn't. We're going to hell. That's like the absolute opposite of okay.
Oh my God.
Look, guys, just know that I didn't do any of this on purpose. I was so confused. She had me pinned up against the wall. She sounded so convincing.
Wait, Jason, what did you say?
The devil's a smooth
talker. No. She was holding you against the wall.
Well, like, I couldn't move. I was sort of like floating.
But you were being forced against the wall, Jason. You struggled?
Yeah.
I have no rebuttal. I'm just making a new point.
Proceed.
Scratch claims he's had this meeting with my client. Mr. Stone claims the same thing. But how do we know? I wasn't there. The jury wasn't there. You were not there, Your Honor. So how do us third parties even know what happened? Jason has a fragile mind. Quite frankly, he's an idiot. He could have hallucinated. Scratch is the devil. Can we really put lying past her? I guess what I'm getting at, Satan, where's your proof?
Oh, Danny, a very poor point to make.
Sweet flames of hell, did anybody see that magic?
I hope this wasn't your last attempt, Mr. Webster. So, you wanted this bad, huh?
What the heck?
I've dealt with some doozies, but this one's really shallow, Jason.
That is excellent cinematography.
Who are you?
Yeah, I have a few names. Let's just get to the proof.
Rewind it.
4 years, Jason. You already got your proof.
Stop. There. Hit play.
This is ridiculous. Stop it. Stop it, please.
Jason, you're in.
Scratch. I,
Face it. Without me.
It appears that the defendant used force to obtain the soul. The prosecutor did not sign the contract under his own terms. Jury?
Guilty!
I too find the defendant guilty. Court dismissed!
What have I done?
Yes!
Man, that was incredible. Just, thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry about everything. None of this was worth losing you as a friend, dude. I know that sounds... Just thank you.
Jason, you're still my best friend. That hasn't changed for me.
No, me neither, dude.
You're still a shallow jackass, though.
I know. Look, guys, I'm not gonna waste your time. I got exactly what I wanted. I really did. But I guess I... sounds really lame. I guess I didn't know exactly what I wanted.
But you do now. That's sweet. Have we all made up? Are we friends forever?
Sorry it didn't work out for you, Scratch. Well, not really.
It's all good. Well, not really, but I had fun. Congratulations on your win, Mr. Webster. And Jason, congratulations. Soul's all yours. And Mary, I don't really know you. You should talk more.
Well, I was...
Anywho, I'd best be splitting. I've got people to tempt, souls to steal. You know how it is.
Yeah. Sure do.
I'll see you guys soon.
That early.
What? Oh! Dude, I got you. The look on your face, you were so scared. It was wonderful, dude. I wish I was filming it.
Oh. Wow. Dude, we were like scared or anything. You totally surprised us. Weren't scared though. So dude, you and Candace.
Look, dude, you don't care if I sort of left at it, do you?
Sam, be my guest.
So I guess you're not coming to her pool party then. I mean, we're still gonna go.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. That's cool, right?
Yeah, that's cool, right?
Yeah, it's fine. I sort of have plans for Friday night anyway.
Alright. Cool, dude. Bye.
Alright, let's split. Jason, you wanna ride? Yeah, sure.
I'll catch up with you guys later. I'm gonna use the little girl's room.
Alright, and... Guys, thank you. You really are great friends. I mean, you stood up to Satan for me. That's kind
of
cool.
All right. Enough of this making up crap. Any more of it, and I'll be forced to assert my masculinity by beating the crap out of you.
All right, we'll see you in a few minutes.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Jason! What are you doing after school, Jason?
Nice butt!
I swear they weren't there a second ago. Look, girls, I'm just gonna hang out with some friends after school.
Aww. I still like your butt. You're busy?
No surprise there, I guess. Have fun, Jason.
Girls, would you want to come hang out with us?
Really? Jason?
If it's cool with Danny, I guess.
Definitely.
You know, ladies, I'm thinking of going to law school. Yeah.
So you want them this bad, huh?
If the sun vaporized one day, and the moon just faded away, but we still keep going on at the speed of a maddening pace. Sure, the birds fall to the ground and the fish die of thirst. Would we still keep on living the way it's always been? Not if the air could burn our lungs and the earth were only rocks. Would it make us stop and realize that we want, that we can't go on like this? Children's eyes, can we still keep going on living when the monster turns on us?